always think of you when spring comes. Like it's something in
What's going on, guys? Justin from Fitment Industries. We are at my house with RX8. Kind of going over, just doing a quick Q&A session of the progress of the build so far. So if you guys haven't watched all the earlier episodes, make sure you go do so. We've done quite a bit to this car already. It's going crazy fast. I'm super excited. And just thank you guys for all the support on this build so far, through messages, through comments, through just the nice words being thrown around. It's been absolutely awesome. I've been having a blast with this car. I'm glad you guys are enjoying the build as well. And don't forget to follow me on my Instagram, gels.fi, if you want to see some more behind the scenes stuff that maybe didn't make it into an episode, or if you want to get a little sneak peek at some things that are going on off the camera, I guess you could say. So we are not working on the RX8 today. We are just waiting on some stuff to come in yet. But in the meantime, we're gonna go through and just kind of answer your guys' questions, some of the top questions we've been getting about the build. And then next week, we got the parts in. We're gonna be go, go, go. We got the wrap, we got the wing, we got a whole bunch of other stuff coming in. So we thought in the meantime, just give a little break, give a little update where everything's kind of at, what needs to be addressed yet, what has been addressed. And of course, like I said, just answer some questions. So before we go ahead and get into it, don't forget, Wheelstar Suspension, FitmentIndustries.com. Let's go through the community post here. Connor asked, do you think the RX8 gets unjustified hate because it followed the legendary FD RX7? I would say, yeah, it's probably, you know, involved with that. I mean, to be fair, the car does have its faults. You know, I think everyone is aware of that. The engine in the FD RX7 is a little bit more reliable. It's not as temperamental as the Renesis motor. And yeah, I think the FD is a very difficult car to follow up with, you know, especially when you look at it today. And I think it's just like kind of any other revival of like an older car. You know, you look at the new Supra, for instance, you know, compared to like the Mark IV, you know, not saying that this is a Supra by any means, but you know, it's like when you take a legendary car that we all know from the 90s and you kind of bring it into the 2000s, whenever that might be, as like the next generation of that, I think, yeah, it gets a little tough. Official Andres asks, what build on it has brought you the most happiness so far? So I would imagine, what have we done so far that's brought me the most happiness? Honestly, I think probably the wide body. That's obviously one of the most drastic changes that we've done to it. I've enjoyed every process of the way so far. The air suspension, a little more tedious. That took quite a few days, actually about a week to do entirely to get it up and running. But that's just because, you know, haven't done a lot of that before, and especially with like a new system like the D2 struts and stuff like that. A little bit of a learning curve, but I think the wide body, you know, the most drastic change, and then I think it looks damn good. I'm super excited about it. Travis Haar asks, what color are you considering wrapping it in? Well, I'm not gonna give that away just yet, but my first choice, if it was in stock, couldn't find it anywhere, search eBay, search like other wrap shops around the area, didn't have it. It was like a cinder red metallic from 3M. Not going that color, and I'm not even going red anymore, so I'll kind of leave it at that. We got a video coming up pretty soon. We're gonna be diving into wrapping in this thing next week. So whenever that video lands, you guys will see that. But I'm really excited about it. The color looks really good. Tulip36 says, is it out of oil yet? Yeah, almost. The oil cooler lines on these things are a bit of a freaking rough spot, especially when it comes to cars in the northern part of the country. Yeah, the one like corroded to all hell. I actually replaced that last week with a Mishimoto line. Now we're good. Yeah, it was leaking a ton of oil. It was progressively getting worse. When I picked up the car, it was just a couple drops here and there, and then it turned into like a puddle, which turned into like a river of oil. So yeah. Jesse Van Arsdal wants to know, are you planning on doing any performance mods? Yeah, further down the road, like I said, a lot of stuff had to go into this to get to the car where it is now. And then to be able to do the videos for the channel, I absolutely want to do some performance stuff. Whether that's, you know, getting another Renesis motor and bridge porting that in the meantime and kind of building that up, or if I just want to dive in all into like an REW swap. I want to keep a rotary in it. I'm not going LS. I don't care what anyone says. I want to keep a rotary in it. That's why I got the car. So yeah, we'll see. I, you know, the exhaust and stuff like that, I might throw a tune on it if I can find a decent tune. But you know, they make pretty much their peak horsepower from the factory. Like they, Mazda squeezed as much power as they could out of this engine already. So there's really not any room for improvement on that aspect unless you go force induction. Saber Felipe, any plans on a new set of wheels? I'm just curious since he put it on Air Ride and wide body it before he did the wheels. Yeah, so we did kind of our best to, you know, see where it was gonna be with the wide body in air with these wheels. So they are 18 by 10.5 plus 22 in the rear, 18 by 9.5 plus 20 in the front, and then a 30 mil and a 50 mil spacer. So we did our best to kind of judge that without even having anything on the car. Rears came out good, fronts obviously with the camber and everything like that, not so good. But yes, I'm working on having some multi-piece wheels made up. Really excited about that. I've seen a couple renders so far. We just gotta get the sizes down, which we'll be doing here soon. But of course, with multi-piece wheels, it's gonna be a few weeks. It might be a little bit before, you know, all of that is ready. But yes, new wheels are in the works. They are on the way. Petrol enthusiast, this is the most important question to be asked about all RX-8 owners. Did you make the RPM buzzer go off? What was your reaction when it did? It honestly scared the shit out of me. I thought like a light went off or something. I'm like, okay, yep, that's it. I blew it up. It's over. Any plans to facelift the car or maybe just an R3 style bumper for pre-facelift? Maybe. I think it's gonna be kind of tough with this kit just because it is molded to the S1 bumper. And you know, it does flow throughout the whole front end. I think a swap like that would require a lot of modification to the over fenders right now. Maybe sometime, like maybe next year when ready to take the wrap off, either wrap it something else or get it painted, maybe look into something like that. But right now, no plans of that. I know Lion's Kit does make like an R3 style bumper that looks really good. I love the look of it. Like I said, it's just making it work with the over fender kit here. I think it might be a little tricky. The godparents asking the real questions. Do you prefer this to your FRS? That's a tough one. I absolutely love my FRS, but I also love this thing, but for completely different reasons. Like, this thing is just like rowdy and crazy and weird and kind of stupid at the same time, but I love it because it just shoots massive fireballs now for like whatever reason. The FRS is just like a solid, fun daily driver for me that I've had fun modifying, and you know, it sounds good, it you know, looks good. You know, they are kind of comparable. They're sub 200 horsepower rear wheel drive manual cars. It's just that this is an entirely different engine platform. I would say right now I'm having more fun with the RX-8 just because it is, you know, going through such an extensive change, but I still love my FRS, don't get me wrong. Miata Man wants to get you an RX-8, wants to know how much would be a good price for a clean RX-8, and would you deem it a possible daily driver, or is that too much to ask? Honestly, I think right now, $5,000 to $6,000 is a pretty decent entry point, depending on the year. The 2004 is going for around $4,000 to $5,000. I paid $6,000 for this one, just because it had such low miles. But if you're looking into like the newer ones, you're probably looking more around like $8,000 to $9,000, maybe $10,000 for like a really clean one. It really depends, but you can look out because, you know, these cars are so weird and they do have so many just like weird issues that people are like, oh yep, the engine's blown, don't want to deal with it. And it's something as easy as like a starter or something like that that is too weak, or ignition coils need to be replaced, and people just dump them for like $500. And like, I've seen people just snagging up absolute gems of RX-8s for just stupid cheap. So like, keep your eyes out. And if you know what you're looking for, I would honestly just ask someone who has had multiple RX-8s, be like, hey, would you come with me to come check this out? And it could be something really easy. You never know, you can snag a really decent one for not a lot of money. So thank you guys so much for the questions. I guess just a quick overview of where we're currently sitting right now. We gotta get the fitment a little dialed in yet, so we gotta take those measurements for the multi-piece wheels. Kinda gotta go through and adjust all the air struts yet, a couple of the ride height adjustments just to help dial everything in. This side does sit a little bit higher, which bugs the shit out of me. We gotta finish the trunk setup. I'm working up some drawings in CAD just to kinda get a rough idea of what I wanna do. I think it'll be really nice. And then we'll tackle that. That should be in the near future. Clean up the headlights, just get some simple like TLC things done, get some of the dents pulled before we wrap it, just like some little minor dents. This thing's got like little dents all over it, I don't understand. But yeah, just clean her up a little bit before we kind of move forward. And I think a lot of that stuff we'll do off camera, just because, you know, restoring headlights just isn't the most exciting thing in the world, you know, versus like installing a big wing or wide bodying it or throwing it on air. So yeah, I'm super excited. Thank you guys so much for watching. Don't forget Wheels, Tires, Suspension, FitmentIndustries.com. Stay tuned next Monday for the next episode of the RX-8 build. I promise we'll install something, but it was really fun reading your guys' comments and questions. We'll see you then.